Give us clean hands, give us pure hearts. Let us not lift our souls to another. Oh God, let us be a generation that seeks your face. Oh God of Jacob, oh God, let us be a generation that seeks your face. Oh God of Jacob, we bow our heart, we bend our knees. Oh Spirit, come make us humble. We turn our eyes from evil things. Oh Lord, we turn down our idols. So give us clean hands, Lord. Give us pure heart. Let us not lift our souls to one another. Give us clean hands. Your heart, let us not lift our souls to one another. Oh God, let us be a generation that seeks your face. Oh God of Jacob, oh God, let us be a generation that seeks your face, oh God of Jacob. Yes, Lord, this is our prayer tonight, this morning, O God. The Lord, we want you, Lord, to be your people, O God, seeking your face, Father. O God, always, Lord, looking at Jesus Christ. For Lord, you are our Savior. You died for us, O God. And Lord, as we sang this morning, Lord, you took away all our iniquities at the Calvary. And Lord, we owe it all unto you, Lord Jesus, this morning. We thank you, Lord, for this time. Lord, help us, Lord, today to worship you. Lord, even as we meditate on this word, God, this psalm you've given us, help us to understand, God, as you speak to us. Help me, Lord, to share this word, God. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise God, hallelujah. Well, I just be in the presence of God, and I just want to thank God for this time He has given us, and especially to be here with the Lelam congregation to worship together. And you all be in prayer. I'm just asking the Lord to help me to speak in a few words at least in Malayalam. So please pray for me, okay? This Psalm 26, you know, is a psalm of David. It's a very personal psalm. As you read through that psalm, you know, it's very, very personal, and it's an intimate prayer of David. And you can actually divide that whole 12 verses into two distinct sections. The first 5 verses, if you read, you see the confidence of David. David's confidence about who he is and his relationship with his God. And then the verses from 6 to 12, it's a determination of what I'm going to do for this God whom I trust. Hallelujah. You know, I believe that today, as we read this psalm, as we are in the presence of God, we should have the confidence that I know whom I trust. Hallelujah. It is my God who is with me and who has led me, as we sang the song. You know, at the Calvary, the Lamb of God was slain. Hallelujah. And His blood has removed that sin stain from my life. Are you confident today? Praise God. Hallelujah. Vindicate me, Lord. See how he's starting this. Lord, you vindicate me. Or in other words, God, it's not about who is around me, but I want you to judge me. Why? Praise God. Because people around me, my brothers, my sisters, my wife, my children, they do not know me. Praise God. But you know, Lord, you know everything about me. Praise God. You know what's in my mind. You know what's in my heart. You know everything, Lord. Because when I was being born, when I was in my mother's womb, you knew me. Praise God. You know everything about me. So, Lord, I want you to judge me. Not those who do not know me, because they'll be unfair. You see what I'm saying? We can actually put on an act. You know, wear a show. We can show off to be very holy. But God knows what is inside your heart. Praise God. So that's why David is saying, you vindicate me, Lord. Hallelujah. But at the same time, David is confident. You know, God, I know that when you judge me, I will come out as pure gold, just like Job said. Hallelujah. I know that, Lord, when you judge me, I will be blameless. Praise God. See, this is a confidence. We should have the confidence that, you know what, today if God judges me, what will be the verdict? Praise God. Will he find me blameless? Hallelujah. This morning I just want to challenge you. And at the same time, I want to encourage each one of you here today. Praise God. That this God whom we are serving and who has chosen us, we didn't choose him. He chose us. That I will be blameless when he vindicates me. I have trusted in the Lord without wavering. Praise God. So David is saying, you know, I have put my trust, my complete trust and a complete vishwasam, I have put in my Lord, not on Saul or his kingdom or his power. No, my trust is in the Lord. Hallelujah. And that trust was not wavering. Two days, when it's not all right in the office, your vishwasam is all gone down. And you're doubting whether I'll get sacked or how my kids are going to study. No, that's not what we're talking about here. I trust in the Lord without any kind of doubts. Praise God. You know, when I was studying that, I was thinking of Peter. When he said, Lord, if it is you, ask me to come. And Jesus said, come. And Peter, even at that moment, he was conversing with the Lord. You see, he's making a conversation. When you make a conversation, you look at that person, correct? Yeah, you actually should look into their eyes. I mean, you know, we have a lot of people there and they talk. That's not what I'm talking about. You look into that person, you converse, you talk. There is communication. He spoke to Peter and Peter spoke back to Jesus. There was a conversation. And in that conversation was Peter's faith and his belief, because it is a word of God. Praise God. And in that faith, he went down. He went out. He came. He took his step out of the boat. Praise God. There was 11 other people inside the boat. What happened to them? Why didn't they get out of the boat? Because they did not have the conversation. Praise God. Hallelujah. Brother, sister, I'm telling you, when you are in that intimate relationship with Jesus Christ, when you are conversing, when you are actually having a close relationship with God, when you are speaking to God, and when God is speaking to you, hallelujah, you will have the faith to step out of the boat. Hallelujah. Even Abraham, there's so much I want to share, but if you study that Genesis chapter 17, God said. It's a lengthy conversation with Abraham. And God was building the faith of Abraham when he was 99 years old. God spoke to him. And I believe Abraham was walking on the word of God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So today you see here, I trusted in the Lord without any reason. David is saying, I have trusted in him completely because I know he took care of me. He delivered me. He took me from the wilderness and he placed me in his throne. Praise God. Verse 2, and I'll close here. Test me, O Lord. And try me. Look, after the vindication, after judging, David is saying, it is not enough. It is not enough, Lord, after to judge me. But you know what? He's going one more step forward. Praise God. And that is the greatest challenge in the child of God. Test me. Hallelujah. Who is ready for a test? Praise God. We all kind of back off from the test, right? Judge, okay, Lord, judge me, you know. I'll take it. The verdict, whatever it is, punishment, I'll take it. But here is the thing. David is saying, now, Lord, test me. And he's very particular about what his test is. My heart and my mind. Praise God. Amen. Remember one thing. Your mind and your heart is the most precious thing in your life. Praise God. Because the mind is where the thoughts are processed. Ella chindagalum nammude manasula, it processes first. It comes as a thought first, it'll come in our minds. And if you spend some time on those thoughts, slowly, because of the gravity, these thoughts will slowly drift down to your heart. And your heart is where the desires, the thoughts become a desire. You want it now. You really want to feel it or do it or see it or speak it or hear it. So the desire comes to your heart. And then you spend some more time, that desire will become an action. That's why guard your mind. The word of God says, guard your mind. Set your mind on things that are above. Praise God. Where Jesus Christ is seated on the right hand side of God the Father and is interceding for us. Hallelujah. Set your mind and your heart. You know, if you want, you can go back home and read from Philippians chapter 12, 5 to 11. You will see about the mind and the heart. You know, in John 7, 38. God desires something else for our hearts. Living waters that will bring life. It should flow out of us from our hearts. That's why it's so precious for God. Because out of your hearts will bring life to others. Namare hridayathina, what does it happen? When your heart is full of life that Jesus has given you, it will come out of your mouth. Praise God. What is in your heart? Other than our samsari. So, out of our heart should come living waters. That means water that gives life. Jeevan tarune vellam should come out of our hearts. This is what God desires. Praise God. But sometimes what happens? Out of our mouth something else comes. Whoa, where did that come from? Praise God, from your heart. Nowhere else. Just have to test and see. That's why David is saying, test me, Lord. Test me. And try me. Talking about it, just a quick word. You know, sportsmen and soldiers. Avare oru prasam select cheyidittu then that's it. Lifelong they can be just soldiers? No. Periodically they have to be tested. Are they fit for the war? They'll keep testing you. They will send you through rigorous training. They'll test you whether you're able to, your aim is still right. I think you'll be shooting here and you'll be going there. You'll probably shoot your own person. So they will test you continuously. Same way the Lord, David is saying, Lord, test me. Today, this morning, let me ask you, how long you've been in this faith? I don't care. Today, if the Lord tests you, how will you be, brother? Are we ready for a test? God, can you say, Lord, test me and try me today, and I know. Praise God. And I'm confident that I will come through. For your love is ever before me, and I walk continually in your strength, in truth. Your love, God's love, Devathinte Sneham is continually, praise God. How many of us can say that? That we are walking, and all the time, God's love, Devathinte Snehathile nammal eppozhum nadakkunnennu. How many of us can say that? Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Because that is what the Lord is saying, we have to. Because I believe only when you have God's love with you, you can walk in His truth. Praise God. இது ரெண்டும் ஒருமிச்சு கேட்டோம். God's love and His truth. If you want to walk in the truth of the Word of God, you have to have God's love in your presence all the time. Continually, all the time. Praise God. So this morning, I just want to encourage these words. Like David, are we confident today? Are we confident about our walk with God? And then if we are confident, are we ready to do something for God today? Can we stand and praise God and say, Lord, I am here and I will give you praise in the congregation. I know that I am standing on a level ground that I will give praise to God. Hallelujah. Close your eyes this morning. Father, Lord, I thank you for this psalm you've given us, God. Thank you for your word, God. Thank you for speaking to us. And Lord, I pray that, Lord, you continue to minister to us today, even as we are in your presence, God. And the Lord's table is here, God. And help us, Lord, to be honest and faithful. And Lord, help us, Lord, to be worthy, God, to take part in your table, Father. Certainly, Lord, everything in mighty hands. Bless thyself, anoint them, Lord, Father. Lord, use us, Father, to minister to your people, God.